Hey there guys, welcome back to the channel. Thank you very much for clicking on the video. I hope you're all well. In this video, we're going to talk a bit about practice posture. So I've been guilty of sitting with bad posture playing the guitar for so long. Well, since I started playing, I used to lie on my bed and do it, which wasn't that bad, but sitting in this position for long periods and arching, hunching over my back. I've got a bad back anyway, and I had a bad back when I started playing the guitar, so it wasn't too great that I was sitting like that all the time. And I used to go to physiotherapy for it and that sort of thing. And when I came to uni, I'd just been on a cruise and had a acupuncture done, and that had really helped me. And then as soon as I came off that cruise, really, for the holiday, I came to uni. So I ended up at uni and lost a lot of weight, which then solved a lot of my back problems as well, because I was walking all the time and I had a lot of strength in my back. But since we've been off with this virus, I've had a lot more time to practice, but also a lot more time not to be outside exercising and not reasons to be walking to uni all the time, because I'd walk to uni 2 or 3 times a day because I had rehearsals. So I would walk home and walk here when I had rehearsals and things like that. So essentially I feel like I've put on weight as a person, and I need to sort that out. But mainly my back has started to give me small problems again sometimes, and I think it's due to the fact that I'm sitting playing guitar like that. So what I bought myself is this. It's a Tiger footstool. You can get similar ones from Anderton's, I believe. I think I got this one from Amazon. Literally put in guitar footstool on Anderton's or Amazon, whatever, and you'll find this one if you want to get the same one. And basically it's got a load of hooks here, so you can change the how tall it is. So you can like pull that out, click it there, so if you're on a higher stool or something. And then I have it on the second ring in because that's where it's comfortable for me. So basically what this does is it rises your left foot, if you're right-handed guitarist, that is. So you're gonna put your left foot on it, put it there, and then there your guitar sits like this now. So it's more like you're standing up. So for the people who are learning things for standing up and to play standing up at shows, this is a really handy thing to sit and learn using, because it puts you in the same position rather than this position here, which is, you know, you're down like that and bent over. You don't play live like that. You play live with your guitar like this, stood up straight. So immediately, as soon as I do this, you can see in my posture, in my back, that it's up. Whereas if I do this to play, I'm slouching, sitting up properly with proper posture. So this has helped me massively. Yeah, so this has helped me in the last month. I don't know, I think it's a month of having it. I've used this almost exclusively when I practice, and then I'll stand up as well and play my videos now. Sometimes I'll still be in this position. Don't get me wrong, I don't do it. I'm not saying I use it exclusively. I use it most of the time for practice. And most of the time for videos, I'll have my foot on this if I'm sitting down, or I'll be standing up, because I've got a little camera set up, well, a tripod set up there where I put my phone in to film my videos. So yeah, it was just really to bring this to the attention of more people. I've got a couple of little playing segments lined up. By the way, this is probably the last time you'll see this look like this. A little bit of a juicy nug for you there. Anyway, so what I've done is I've just wrote a little like sort of funky couple of chords this morning and just sort of like played around with them and that sort of thing. And what I've done is I've recorded them with the footstool and without the footstool, just trying to be as comfortable as I can in both positions. And you'll see by the posture that I've taken it that I look like this, and I might turn my neck and like sort of look down, but I'll be I'll be able to see what's going on without doing this. And on the other one, I'm sort of sat like this and watching what's going on. So you can see immediately the posture difference. So I put them as the one with the footstool first, then without, just to really showcase how much it affects it. And why I think everyone needs these. I've not seen anybody with them apart from myself now. Tim Henson had one in his studio tour. I saw his studio tour on YouTube and spotted he had one of these. He said, oh, there's my footstool. And Jason Richardson was the one who talked about it in his Captain Meats video. And he was very vocal about the advocacy of this for posture reasons and just because it helps him. So, thank you very much for watching the video. This has been a different video. I normally say that at the start of the video, but it has been a bit of a different one. It's more of like a tips and tricks sort of thing. If you do like this type of video and you want me to cover more stuff, then please do consider hitting that like button. It does help me out a lot. Leave a comment in the down below if you've got any feedback for me. I'm always welcome to feedback on things and making the content better. And if you do want to see some more content, then please do hit that subscribe button. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye.